I'm about to meet the CEO of Mind Candy, a fierce ping pong player, and also a man with an OBE in the coolest office in London. Come on, let's go.
So I'm here at Moshi HQ. I'm actually in the treehouse, guys, I know. With the man himself, with Mr. Moshi, Michael Acton Smith. Hello!
Hello.
Okay, so we're going to go right back to the beginning.
Oh, that's rewind.
Oh, yeah, rewind. We're going to go right back to the beginning. Because obviously, Moshi Monsters is something that you're massively famous for, CEO of the company. But also, it's a little bit bigger than that, isn't it? So you started Mind Candy.
Yes.
Which sort of started with something called Firebox. So how did that all come about?
Well, Firebox was my first official company. When I was very little, at like sort of age about 7 or 8, I used to set up my own entrepreneurial ventures. I had a BMX stunt show. I had a little computer games magazine. I used to wash people's cars, all that kind of usual stuff. Then I grew up, went to university, and set up Firebox. Although originally it was called Hotbox.
Okay.
Because we sold these products that were so hot, they were literally bursting out of the box. So gadgets and toys and games. But we couldn't call it Hotbox, because even though we'd registered hotbox.co.uk, hotbox.com was one of the world's biggest porn sites. Was really awkward.
Lovely!
Yes.
That's not what you want, really.
No,
it's
a bit embarrassing because my mum would go and tell all her friends to check out her son's amazing new company, and they'd end up at the wrong place. So we changed the name to Firebox.com, and Firebox is still going strong to this day.
Yes. Just saying, something else got created after
something
that,
else
didn't
happened. I can't quite remember what it was.
Exploded. No, what?
This colourful, creative, crazy world called Moshi Monsters.
Moshi! What kind of drove you to go more towards the children sort of, you know, genre?
Well, I've never fully grown up, so...
Okay, me neither.
Good! I think all the best people are.
Yeah.
Wandering through life with childlike wonder and curiosity. And I used to read all these amazing books when I was younger, The Hobbit and Dr. Seuss and Roald Dahl books. And so I think there's always been that kind of bubbling away in my head.
Yeah.
And when Perplexity didn't work, I went to various coffee shops and was just doodling ideas and scribbling and thinking. to be able to doodle, it's very important. And one day I had too many espressos and I drew this little monster. And I thought, wouldn't it be amazing if it could pop to life off the paper and you could adopt it and look after it. So that was the very first seed of the idea that grew into Moshi.
Wow. And now there are literally thousands of Moshis, aren't there?
Millions of Moshis all around the world.
Got a favourite? I mean, I know it's going to be difficult.
Well, there's a few in this room. There's, I don't know if you can see him, just above your head, in fact.
Okay.
He's this little chap called Big Bad Bill.
I love him!
So he's pretty amazing.
How did you come up with these names? These are cool names.
So there's an amazing guy I've worked with since the start called Steve Cleverly, who is a creative genius. And we often kind of have very fun conversations talking about characters, and he names loads of them.
Yeah.
He comes up with the bios, but some are named after people from our lives.
Okay.
One is named after my niece. Have you got a favourite Moshi?
I have.
Do you? What's
I
your
have.
Favorite?
My favourite, my favourite colour is pink.
Is
so
it? I'd never have guessed.
I know, right? It's got to be Poppet. I mean,
Poppet's
amazing. Poppet is massive and pink, and she's just beautiful.
She's
and
very
love
cute.
Her.
She wears a little bow.
Exactly.
Yes, all the girls love Poppet.
Yeah.
You know, I think it's amazing creating something, first of all, that kids love.
Yeah.
They're such an amazing audience. They're so honest. If they don't like something,
they
will tell you. And when they love something, my God, it's the most extraordinary thing.
Yeah.
So we do live events where they come and they want their kind of posters and their toys signed. And some of them are so nervous, they're like crying and shaking. It's just it's just incredible to have this big fan base. So we love it.
If you follow Michael on Twitter, then you'll see a couple of things about ping pong.
I thought, with a couple of friends of mine, Alex and my girlfriend Catherine, I thought, why don't we create our own ping pong tournament? So Ping Pong Fight Club was born, and all the other startups thought it was hilarious. So the other day, in this big, beautiful warehouse called Second Home, we got Facebook, Moo, Spotify, LastFM, Skimlinks, One Fine Stay, Unruly Media, Mind Candy, Decoded, Listora. All these companies turned up with their best ping pong players, and we battled it out on the ping pong table until only one person was left standing.
We're going to go and have a little look around. We're going to explore.
All right.
Lovely to meet you.
Very nice to meet you too.
Take care.
Bye-bye. Ladies and gentlemen,